Okay, let's go to our other big story. Almost a year since she was found dead in a Delhi hotel. Still no breakthrough in the Sunanda Pushkar Tharoor death. Now we've seen dramatic twists and turns in the last 36 hours. And the Delhi police has now decided that a special investigation team will look up the case and also has rejected an allegation by Congress MP Shashi Tharoor alleging a frame-up. Ankit Tyagi has the latest.
Allegations of a framing attempt and the formation of a special investigation team. Developments in the mysterious death of Sunanda Pushkar have taken a series of dramatic turns in the last 36 hours. After deciding to probe the case as murder, the Delhi police is now all set to question Congress MP and Sunanda's husband Shashi Tharoor. DCP South will be heading the SIT and will monitor the probe closely.
जिससे भी हमें कॉन्टैक्ट करना है और कब करना है, किस प्रकार से करना है, वो हम हमारा एक्शन प्लान है हमारे पास में. पूरी SIT बनाई गई है. SIT इसके ऊपर में काफी गंभीरता से इसको देख रही है.
A letter written by Shashi Tharoor to the Delhi Police Commissioner in November last year has added a fresh twist to the case. In a letter dated 12th November 2014, Tharoor complained to Delhi Police about one of the Delhi Police officers intimidating and physically assaulting his servant to confess that he and Tharoor murdered Sunanda Pushkar. There is, however, still no clarity on what killed Sunanda. The AIIMS medical report has concluded that her death was unnatural and due to poisoning.
In medical science, it is a very complicated issue. There are various reasons of non-detection of poison. But the medical finding or autopsy finding is the conclusive finding to establish the cause of death.
As investigators probe injury marks found on Sunanda's body, the medical report from a Kerala hospital where Sunanda Pushkar had undergone treatment days before her death says that she was suffering from an autoimmune disease for which she was prescribed medicines. The doctors there say one of the side effects of the prescribed medicines was excessive bruising.
The probe into high-profile death of Sunanda Pushkar has now been fast-tracked. But a letter written by Congress MP Shashi Tharoor to Delhi Police Commissioner has added another dramatic twist in this case. Already the flip-flops in the autopsy and the viscera reports have shrouded Sunanda Pushkar's death into mystery. And a year since her death, nobody still knows what killed Sunanda Pushkar. In New Delhi, with cameraperson Kashif, Ankit Tyagi for Headlines Today.
Okay, let's go then straight to our newsmaker at the moment. Even as these twists and turns take place in the Tharoor case, I'm joined by Meher Tarar, Pakistani journalist who, remember, was involved in a Twitter war with Sunanda Pushkar Tharoor just 2 days before, or really a few hours before Sunanda Pushkar Tharoor was found dead, and that led to more complications. Now she wants to come and give her side of the story. Appreciate you joining us there, Meher, from Pakistan. Now, every time there is a twist in Sunanda Pushkar Tharoor's case, your name is dragged in. How do you respond when the likes of Subramaniam Swamy say that you in some way could be held responsible because allegedly you were in a relationship with Shashi Tharoor?
The only reason why I've decided to talk to you today is because I am sick and tired of being targeted for something I had nothing to do with. Right. I can't keep on. I found out on Twitter, just like all of you did. I know Shashi Tharoor for a while. I did not know him when his wife decided to tweet to me. First and foremost, I want to say one thing to you very clearly, categorically, which I can say on oaths if the police ever decides to question me. Everything she said to me on Twitter was untrue. I'm saying this to you today. I can say this on oath. I can say this in any court in the world in front of anybody, putting my hand on whatever I'm supposed to put my hand on if I take an oath. So if everything she said to me was untrue, why have bits been taken from her tweets to me and used against me and her husband after her death. She called me an ISI agent. She talked about IPL. She said a number of very personal things to me, to which I did not respond because I did not think they merited any response. Now, other than that, a lot of what is said about me are based on the tweets she sent to me. Now, the problem is nothing she said to me was true. So how come everything that is said to me and I'm being judged on is based on what she said?
I want clarity today because, you know, this is an opportunity for you to have your side of the story. Are you telling me you had never anything to do with Shashi Tharoor in the manner that was alleged by Sunanda Pushkar Tharoor?
No, I'm not saying that I did not have anything to do with him. We were friends. We stopped being friends. We weren't even in touch with one another when she got in touch with me on Twitter. And that is the truth. I can say, as I said, I can say this on. I found out about her tweets. I mean, I found out that she was in a fight with her husband when I was tagged in the tweets. I found out she was in a hotel and died 2 days later when somebody texted to me from Delhi and said, this is what has happened. I didn't even know where she was. I didn't even know where they were. Nobody got in touch with me. I did not know what was happening in their life. All I knew was what was happening on Twitter. She became quiet. I think it was the 17th morning. She kept on tweeting to me. Rahul,
right.
The cover history of tagged in a number of those tweets. The only reason why it's so easy for people to target me is because the three people whose names are in this case, one of them is dead. The other one doesn't talk to them. I'm an easy target. I refuse to be a part of this thing anymore. I refuse to have my country's name dragged into something, which was a personal thing. I knew somebody.
So
I ceased to know that person after a while. Am I going to pay a price for that for the rest of my life? I refuse to.
So you are saying today very categorically you had nothing to do with Mr. Tharoor in terms of a relationship, as was mentioned in the tweets when Sunanda allegedly hacked the account of Shashi Tharoor.
No, everything, all her tweets, even the tweets she sent out from her husband's account, they were all untrue. They were all distorted words, the distortions of a couple of messages I may have sent ages ago. I'm not saying we weren't in touch once upon a time. I'm not saying we weren't friends, you know, we were virtual friends. I met the person twice in my entire life. Now, please, use your common sense. It's not that we're talking about teenagers. We're talking about people in their 20s. This is somebody who was of a certain age. And you know, I mean, he lived in India. I lived in Pakistan. We used to talk about his books. We used to talk about other things too, about our lives, so on and so forth. But that ended a long time ago. The phone records are there for the police to check anytime they want to. They can check my phone bills. They can check his phone bills. We weren't in touch with one another.
Have you spoken, ma'am, to Shashi Tharoor since Sunanda's passing away in the last 12 months?
No, I emailed him when this happened. I emailed him, but then I never heard from him. I don't know if he was uncomfortable about continuing any kind of contact with me after trouble. You know, I can't even, you know, whenever I say something about him, people think that I'm defending him. Mm-hmm. How am I going to defend a man I've had no contact with for more than a year? And secondly, my media trial is based on her tweets to me. All her tweets to me were lies. So what IPL, what was the other thing, the ISI? How do people keep bringing these words in? I don't even understand. Were they a normal, regular couple? Yes, very high profile, but they were normal, regular people. Why are people reading so much into something that they can't figure out? I mean, fine, they can't figure out how she died. But does that mean that somebody killed her? She was in a very high profile relationship. She was a very high profile person. Everybody recognized her. She was in a hotel room where there are CCTV cameras, where there are people walking in and walking out. Somebody would just decide, okay, you know, she's in this hotel room. Let's go and kill her. Why would anybody want to harm her? Has anybody bothered to What this whole IPL thing, I have no idea what IPL is. I don't know how it works in India. There are very, very high profile people in India who are connected to IPL. Why don't Mr. Swamy attack them?
Mr. R, you are saying you have no idea of the IPL, you have no idea of the various issues which were raised by Sunanda Tharoor. Are you saying then the likes of Subramaniam Swamy are today using your name to settle scores in a sense with Shashi Tharoor?
Look, I don't know your country's politics. I don't know what's behind this thing. I'm trying to understand that there has to be a motive. There has to be. Why would somebody want to harm a woman who was tweeting to another woman? Okay, she shouldn't have brought a personal fight on Twitter. But other than that, why would somebody want to harm her? What has she done to anybody? And is Mr. Tharoor a criminal? Does he have a criminal background? Has he ever done anything in his entire life that would put him into the category of somebody who should be a suspect? Mm-hmm. Not just for a small thing, but for the murder of his own wife, directly or indirectly, like your Mr. Swamy and a number of his right-wing supporters seem to imply. Because each time they take his name, they keep dragging my name into this, that Pakistan ISI is involved and the Dubai is involved and four people with Pakistani passports were there. Please stop bringing my country's name into something that was completely personal.
Ma'am, I want to ask you in conclusion. The Indian police today has ordered a special investigation into the case. As you know, yesterday they've said charges of murder in the case, or they're looking at it as a possible murder case. Are you willing to speak to the Delhi police? And if they call you, will you put everything on record?
Of course, any time. I said this the first day, I'm saying this again. Any day they want to talk to me, if they want to ask me anything, if they have any questions whatsoever that they think I can answer, I'm right here. But through you, why are you? The only reason why I wanted to talk to you was you were one of those reasonable people who have not started a media trial of Mr. Tharoor or me, or who are not, you know, who are at least had the good sense to apologize for Sunanda's pictures being splashed in the media yesterday. Stop ruining people's lives. That's all I want to say. Stop dragging my name just because a woman tweeted to me 2 days before she died. Okay. I have nothing to do with this.
Okay, Mayor Tharoor, you've had your say, and I hope that you will, of course, speak to the Delhi police and give your side of the story. Mayor Tharoor joining us on the Sunanda Pushkar Tharoor case, which takes twists and turns every day. Let's take a break and then we'll bring you a quick update of what else is making the headlines. No breakthrough yet as the nationwide strike by coal industry workers enters the second day. Talks between the government and the unions have failed.